At the seventh, the man who won this championship a couple of years ago at the country club, Matt Fitzpatrick.
Very quick down the hill. Look at this. Just gets it started. Even he.
You see that?
Yeah. You'll see those kind of reactions occasionally.
2, 4, 6, 8. Just a couple of players have played those under par.
So Adam Scott's ball, Gary, did trickle down into that
well,
bunker.
It looked like it was going to hang right there on the edge and did not. And that's a very average bunker shot.
Adam Scott, remember, he was bunkered after his second shot. So this is a long par save.
Should go a little right at the end. Oh, there you go. That putter can make up for a lot of mistakes, Steve.
Yes, it can.
They like them fast.
No yes, question. They do. There's Sam Bennett at 3. Much different hole today.
Yeah, certainly so. Yesterday, drivable. Oh, what a shot from Bennett. Tees were moved up some 66 yards.
Let's go all the way up to the ninth. And Jackson Suber.
Yeah, birdie putt here for the young man who got in. Last guy into the field when John Rahm withdrew. Fine young player from my hometown.
At the seventh, Francesco Molinari. Wasn't his week, as you can see by the score, but he will take away the memory of making the cut on the number. Look at that one. Oh! At seven. Making the cut on the number, needing an ace at the ninth, his 36th hole, the first time in U.S. Open history that's ever happened.
And from Republic of Korea, please welcome.
Some players are waiting. It's kind of a little awkward deal because you want to go right over the left side of that back part of 8T. Really no wind right now at all, guys. And this down the left side should be just fine as long as it doesn't run out.
Yeah, he likes to change speeds. He'll tee it down, try and squeeze one in the fairway.
A really good pitch on two. So it's kind of a similar shot, banking into the bank and then let it roll down. Really well done again.
Whoa. Scared the hole.
That's how about a sick up and down? Par. That was a sick up and down, sick putt. Just a great par there.
Just a little bit ingrained for about a foot and then slightly down and to the right. Should kick it to the right.
With authority, that was moving.
To be honest, not that good a putt because it wasn't that difficult.
Frankie Sappen at the third.
Okay. There we go.
That's where you talked about.
Like the putt from. Hole high right. Uphill. A little right to left break. He's very adept at working the ball in both directions by that follow through and trying to hit a little left to right shot. And beautifully played. There we go. Somebody got it in their hole high. Yes, he is out of the event, but you know, there are 90 some odd guys that didn't make the cut.
Right.
That would love to be in his position playing on a Sunday championship Sunday in the U.S. Open.
Oh no, he's taking both breaks. Needs a little pace.
Yeah, that first hop killed him. Saw Spencer knock one down from basically that same zone. Maybe that's the sweet spot on this green.
Where you want to be?
That's where you want to be.
And yes, that yardage was correct.
That was a bit of a foul ball there. Steve, oh, got a great kick. That thing was leaking well to the right.
Look at this shot, Noda.
Let's document that. Oh, it was one of the best kicks of the week right there.
Man.
Lauer, tee at 6, par 3.
This landing right into that false front. That is beautiful.
This guy's got all the shots.
Yeah, this isn't Monday. This is today. Here's Keegan Bradley.
Get left. He didn't like it. Might be a little right. Oh, he got the left-hand hop. If that ball kicks that much to the right, it goes off the green. So sometimes you do get the right bounce.
Pagala back at the second.
talked about this being the toughest hole. The hardest green to hit. Now Spieth and Tagala. Now Tagala's in that spot underneath the hole. Spieth was on the other side of the hole, so.
Hopefully go just right and perhaps a little long this whole location. It will repel back if short.
Have to take dead aim here with a wedge in your hand. Yep, I'd say that's dead aim. There are only so many opportunities, Steve, as we talked about it. This is one, this third hole, if you're in the fairway. Shouldn't be much break here. Just keep the speed up, slightly uphill. Oh, got to keep the speed up.
Oh, after that shot, coming in, unable to take advantage. Only par five on the front side.
In the bunker, and not a bad place to play from today because you're playing back up the hill to the hole, even though the bunker's some 6 or 7 feet below the level of the green.
Perfect tape shots that ran off down the green, so it's incredible, isn't it?
That is. I mean, it just shows the difficulty. Obviously, this is the easiest hole in the course.
Interesting to see how brave Adam gets. Well, this is very brave. This is straight at it. We'll see. One bounce. There you go.
Wow.
That is about as good as you can do at this hole. That's back-to-back birdies for Adam Scott.
Trying to hoist it way up in the air.
Right at it.
And another fine shot. We saw him toward the end of the round yesterday, so he hit a number of really good shots.
Wiggle this one home here. It has been a slog on the greens for Scotty this week.
Oh, man. And there it just continues. My goodness gracious. You can't hit it any better than that.
And to Bones's point, the U.S. Open meant more to him than any other event. He absolutely adored this event and this venue right here behind us at Pinehurst. As we go to the action once again behind us here at one. Look at Veeding.
Yeah,
nice
beautiful
approach.
Shot.
Veeding has a birdie putt. Very similar to the line that Koepka just had. Brooks went to the right. Meeting.
He
had a nice tee shot.
Yeah. Nice way to get your round started.
This is Martin Keimer for a birdie. Getting back to 9 over par. Mentioned earlier he made 2 birdies in his round. Got it back to 8 over, then made that double at the 9th.
No. Grayson Sig, 140, his 30th at the par 5. And hold position in that back left. Coming into the wind, it's going to help him stop the ball a bit better.
He did stop it pretty quickly.
Very nice.
You see another one? Yes.
All right.
Told you the floodgates were going to open after that birdie.
Second shot at 5 upcoming. For Siwoo Kim.
He's trying to play a long iron, land the ball short, and have it run up. Now he wants it to sit, and it's going to. Look at this shot. Wow. Should we have seen 13 eagles here. Another great look for there.
That was something else.
Well, you know, Steve, you draw up shots in your mind, you picture them, the flight, the landing point and everything else, and every now and then it comes off just the way you planned.
That was magnificent. How about a 3 at the 5th for Siwoo?
It's got a bit of pace.
Oh, hey, that is such a well played hole for Siwoo.
Got it turning right to left. Did he start it far enough right? Yes, he did.
Oh, good shot.
Yeah, and that'll leave a nice uphill putt with some right to left break, one you can be very aggressive with.
Sapping for birdie on the way. Take the break.
Yeah,
Is it going to stay? Side door.
How about that?
And since then, he's won five times already. This is Lauer on the tee at nine.
Yeah, turning it from right to left on a good line. It's all about the distance. I would say the distance is really good as well. Beautiful shot.
Come out here and share something like this with your pop.
That's Veeding rolling that one in.
Aggressive line, but a little right.
Needs to stop.
That's gonna.
Oh,
just hang
run,
on.
Run up there and mark that. Before he takes it back, he's just visualizing that ball going in the hole, and he's not gonna make the stroke until he sees it going in.
But he'll have to settle for his four. Jordan Spieth, his second from the fairway at seven.
Spieth has hit driver off this tee, which not many players have this week. This is a green light special here from 103 yards. Leaves it right under the hole. Little right to left break. And he has not made a putt between 7 and 10 feet this entire week. And that trend is going to continue. My goodness.
You can just sense the frustration. Saw that second shot dribble into the bunker for Wyndham Clark. Now here's his third.
Yeah, the lie's perfect. Bit of a deepish bunker, but plenty of green to work with here.
Oh, that is lovely. Really well done. Did he make it?
Oh. Terrific touch from Wyndham. Martin Keimer should be a special walk up 18 for him, I would think, after the memory of 2014.
That's great memories. Are you kidding?
Getting close at Shinnecock the year Brooks Koepka won in 18.
Yeah, final round 63. Eyeing it like he likes it. Eyes are going up and down. That always means the ball's online. When you see their eyes going up and down like that, they're trying to judge whether it's going the right.
He's the only player with multiple 63s. In U.S. Open history is Tommy Fleetwood. Is that one?
Yeah, great stroke there. Kept his head down, stayed nice and still.
And a 50-yard pitch coming up. Landed short of the hole and hopes it checks. Yes, it does. Very nice.
Excellent.
Yeah, good call there, Billy Ray.
And that's exactly where you want to leave it to if you have a 4-footer right below the hole for Grayson Sigg.
Yeah, cannot give the hole away. Can be firm as well.
Yep. Gets that shot back.
Decent line of punch roll. It was a good aggressive move of that one to have speed through the hitting zone. Stay there. Stay there. Nicely done.
That's a great shot. And like I mentioned, after he hit that second shot, pine needles, you're going to get a little more spin out of it. And you can see there's great contact. You could hear it even more when he actually hit it.
Then. Carry it just a few paces on, take the momentum off, and then it dies like that. Made that look pretty easy. That's about as simple as look he's going to get all day.
There you go.
How about you? Same routine.
That's what he tried. Oh, my. Oh, my.
Wow.
That's one heck of a shot right there. Yeah. I mean, that is special.
Yeah, and the downslope was not beneficial there with him trying to elevate. I thought he might drive it into the hill.
Oh, my.
What a four.
Exactly. So when Spieth gives you that kind of praise, that'll tell you how good it was. This is dangerously right, trying to draw to it.
Great shot, Jordan.
Yeah, got that nice little bounce four. That's a great opportunity.
Up at the ninth, heck of a tee shot here from Jordan Spieth.
Very good, and a very makeable putt. Should turn just a little left. Okay, sneaks it in, and you finally made one.
Been like Spieth's when it went left. Lowry hoisting it high in the air at one.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. That's the best we've seen today.
All right, Siwoo's ball did plug in the face of that bunker. He's just got to get it out and tumbling. Craig, this is not fair.
And drips it over the front edge. This is a climbs up that hill.
Yeah, just perfect speed. Different players like to putt different ways. Some putt aggressively.
Still sticking to his guns.
Well, this is hammered.
Is it coming?
Yeah, it's coming. Yeah, this is good.
And that is his go-to shot right
there.
That
last thought in your head, even in motion sometimes, getting you.
Back at the third, JT Poston.
Now watch this putt. Delicate. Play it off the hole.
Wow. Yeah. Beautifully done.
He barely breathed on that one.
Straight downhill with quite a bit of break for such a short putt. And
it's one of the smallest force runs on the course. So you can be aggressive here.
Definitely challenged that right side, and it that'll pay off. He's got a very good birdie look now.
Swinging left at the end. Keep going. Oh.
Oh, he needed one more rotation.
And he had exactly one of those putts that I was just mentioning, it's just you have to be so defensive with it, barely touch it. That gravity didn't quite do enough work. Maybe if it was